Hey guys, Penguin Recordings here, and today I've got some pretty cool gameplay to showcase, and that is Dawn of War 2 on Ubuntu, but we will be using Wine, and Wine will be running through PlayOnLinux. Now previously this game could not run through Wine at all, but today after trying the latest Wine I was able to get it running. So before we jump in, I'm running a Wine prefix which has XNA4 and .NET 4 installed. As far as I know, that's all I've installed in there. If we were to go into configure, you can see it's using the latest 1.7.30 Wine version, and I am using the argument no dwrite because without this, Steam is not able to showcase the text. Alright, so let's put that down and let's start this game up. Now previously it used a Windows Live feature for recognizing achievements and all that. But then SEGA took over and now it uses Steamworks. So as you can see, SEGA right there. So the intro video is not skippable. If you do skip it, it will crash. So I'm going to let it play here. As you can see, so far no problem. I am starting the video in windowed mode first. We are running it at 1600 by 900 and then later on I will jump into full screen. So this is basically the intro video working no problem. I'm gonna skip this part of the video and get straight to the main menu.
You lost this war before you started, fool.
Alright, so the cool intro video is over. We're having a short loading screen here. So what we're seeing in the back here is out of memory. Now previously the main menu did work, I didn't have this issue, but don't worry, let's go into options and graphics. I think that happened after I started messing around with GLX OSD and trying to inject it. So we're running at 1600 by 900. Settings are custom. There are some ultra and high, there are some on low. Basically, what's low and off is post-processing, rain detail, and soft particles. So let's jump straight into the performance test. I'm running on the NVIDIA 340.46 drivers. So as you can see at the main menu just now, it's not perfect, it does seem to have an issue, but I think that issue is caused by me messing around with Wine just now, not so much the game itself. There should be no issues whilst running into the game as you can see here. Graphics render properly. This is a stress test, so we can see the average frames per second at the end of this test, and the lowest frame rate and highest frame rate. I would use GLX OSD, I tried to previously but it didn't work out too well, so I'm not using that to showcase frames per second here. As you can see, the scene gets pretty hectic here. No doubt once you run this at full screen later on in the video, it's going to be a lot heavier because we'll be running at a higher resolution. So far so good, no crashes, all graphics working and the sound is okay. Oh, this is so cool, I never thought I'd see that running on Linux, but now we are. It'd be even cooler, if they could do a native version. So what we see here is that we have the average frame rate at about 50 frames per second. Okay, not so great, considering my card is high-end, it shouldn't be that low, but then again, this is through Wine, it's not native. Maximum frame rate reached up to 90, pretty decent, but then it dropped down to 13 at the lowest. Pretty nasty, but I'm okay with the settings. I'm going to click accept. So once again we are out back at the main menu. It wasn't like this before, it was normal until after I started messing around, so I think that's my fault. I am going to go into Dawn of War 2. Now to note, I did not do anything special with this Wine prefix except install .NET 4 and what was the other thing? .NET 4 and XNA4. XNA4 is not necessary, that was for Terraria. So .NET 4 is really all I installed. And even then, that might not be necessary. The cool thing here is that it notices and reads my Steam Cloud save. So I'm running the continuation from my Windows
Commander,
save file.
The orcs have struck another valuable target.
As you can see, all of this works just fine.
A powerful orc chieftain named Gutwrencher is
no
leading the assault.
Here.
But someone must
have... Let's close that. I have not upgraded these guys. Alright, looks like there's some issue when they try to showcase the models up front. No idea why that is. This is Tarkus. Tarkus, I will give him... What should I give him? Specialized weapons training. Yeah, this is what I was aiming for before this. Yep, this is where I'm going, heading this way with this guy. Let us see the main commander, which is me. I was aiming for strength. And ultimately, I'm looking for regaining health whilst fighting. I have a skill. I know, the health is more important right now. Tarkus is set. Yeah, these guys are pretty much all set. I will give Avitus this ability. And let's jump into a match. One thing I definitely noticed is that the loading here is a lot faster than on Windows. I don't know why, but it is superbly fast. Same thing with Crysis. When Crysis does work, it loads so fast, I don't understand. It's just such a shame that Wine doesn't support DirectX 10 or 11 yet. So this intro video works, and if I'm not wrong, I can skip that intro video without an issue, as we just saw. It's only the beginning intro video that I have to go through. So far, so good.
That wrench's location is marked on your map display, Commander.
I am going to
Commander.
Zoom in.
You will need to fight through the orcs defending him.
Pretty neat. I can go all the way in, zoom in, no issues.
Enemy located.
Okay, let me scroll out and head these guys out. I need these guys
Never
to set up here.
Ready for brothers, we go.
You guys set up behind there. Move in. I want you guys to bomb this house. Hotkeys work as well. Neat. Once you get into action. This is pretty awesome. This is pretty awesome. This is a pretty heavy game, so I'm surprised it's running okay so far. These guys gotta get into position quickly. Attack that. Come on, Commander. I'm not gonna run this all the way to the end. It's gonna be a very long mission if I didn't do that. So I'm going to jump into full screen mode in a moment. Just go on for a little bit, a couple more battles. The skill, not close. I'm pretty surprised this worked. It looks like a combination of having Wine being fixed, bug fixes, and SEGA removing the horrendous Windows Live or Games thing. Was it GFWL, I can't remember what it's called. Glad that's gone. Still a game. So far so good. I keep scrolling in and out, moving around on purpose, trying to push it, see if I can make it crash. Oops, I left him alone. Time to heal. Healing them all. Warcry. Go for the kill, go for the kill. Pretty sweet. I'm gonna take three shots of that. Beauty. Save that to the desktop. Okay. These guys in a little bit further. One more fight with these orcs here, and then I'm gonna jump into full screen mode if I can. If I can't, I'll let you know at the end of the video. This is my commander. Commander, move in, Commander. You are needed on the battlefield. Yeah, push through them just like that. Alright, so that was a bit of the mission gameplay. I'm not going to run through the whole thing because it's going to take too long. So I am going to try and move into full screen mode now. As you can see, it works just fine in windowed mode. And I'm recording at the same time, so you got to put that into calculation as well. So I'm going to jump out of this and jump ahead into the video. Alright, so I'm going to be trying it in full screen mode now at 1920 by 1080p. Let's start it up. Still running through the same Wine prefix.
SEGA.
So far so good. 1920 by 1080p is starting up full screen. So I can't skip the intro video, otherwise it crashed, so I am going to skip this part of the video and jump ahead into the main menu. Alright, so we're in the main menu. I'm going to go to Options, Graphics, set to 1920 by 1080p, same settings as I had it in windowed mode just now. So let's jump to the performance test and see if it is capable of running or not. So far so good, just the main menu and the game avatars are a bit messed up. And I'm pretty sure that's because I played around with GLX OSD, because before this it did not have that issue. Maybe a restart would fix it for me. So far so good, it is running. It's about to get a lot more hectic.
Taking position by the wall.
Still good so far. Here's where it gets really heavy. Can't believe this is running in full screen. It's actually working. I'll have to try and play it to the end though to see how it really runs. But so far, so good. There does seem to be some pixelation there when I saw the effects just now. But nothing I can't survive. Alright, so the test is done. Let's see what results we got. We are seeing pretty much similar, even though I increased the resolution, the average frame rate is still 50, and we still reached a maximum frame rate of 90 plus. However, the minimum frame rate did drop to 10, when previously it was 13, but still that is not bad. From 1600 by 900 to 1080p, this is okay. So let's accept that. I'm gonna go to Campaign, Dawn of War 2. Let's see if I can still see my save files or not. Took a bit of time there to load up. So far so good. I tried this previously, I'm gonna try this one instead this time.
Commander, the orcs have struck
another orc nubs
target.
Sky killer.
Raiding parties.
Gonna skip that, jump straight into action. Cyrus, scout squad. Loading is pretty darn fast, very nice. So all in all, it looks like this game is now playable through Wine. Maybe not perfectly, but it's there. Of course, I have no idea how this is going to be on AMD or Intel systems. I don't even know if you'll be able to run it on those graphics cards, but you'll have to try. At least with Nvidia, it does look like it's possible now. I wonder if Saints Row works now that this works. I gotta give that a shot. Come on, crash land that sucker. Ooh, yeah.
Enemy location flagged on the map, Commander.
Okay, you guys shoot that.
There's a trail of blood straight there.
Keep boasting and the blood will be ours.
Oh, nice one, Cyrus. Like a boss. Okay, I need you to take cover. I need you guys to drop a bomb in there. Have these guys go cloaked and then drop that in there. Here we go. Bam! Beautiful. Let's have them get into action. Come on, Commander, move in. Oh, violence. That's one dead orc. It's too much in it. Why are they British? I never could understand that. I see a capture point. Let's see if I can capture that. Let me move around and see what there is. I see that guy right there. Nope, that's not good enough. I need you guys in. Oh, these guys are getting it good. Come on, Commander. Oopsie daisy, we've got flyers. kill these guys. Look at that action. Nuts to yous. Well, as you can see, it's completely playable right here. I'm playing it on full screen and it's still working great on Ubuntu 14.04. Running the latest Wine 1.7.30. Oh, my commander is gonna go down if I am not careful. Come on, guys, take him out, take him out, take him out. Oh, he's running away. Coward. Can I use a demolition charge on them? Maybe. Let's find out. Nope, they move too fast. Let's grenade these suckers. Boom, shakalaka. Look at them bits. Yep, this definitely works 100% right now. Although, yeah, you can see there's some sort of pixelation going on there with the fire particles. No idea what that's about. Alright, so that is it for this gameplay video, guys. It's pretty cool that this now works right off the bat. You may need .NET 4.0, although I'm not sure if that's necessary or not. I did not install that for this game. I installed it for Terraria. So that is it for this gameplay video, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this, and I hope this comes as good news for some of you, especially those of you who are Warhammer 40k fans. Now, I tried Dawn of War 2 Retribution earlier, and that didn't work, sadly, but I will try it again and see if it works now. At least Dawn of War 2, the base game, and Chaos Rising do work. That is for sure. So, thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed watching, and I hope you get something from this video.